Good evening. Today we have assembled here for a lecture under Dr. S.S. Janaki Memorial Endowment. Dr. S.S. Janaki was former director of the Kupuswami Sastri Research Institute, because of whom this institute got international fame after the demise of Professor Raghavan. She was one of the foremost students of Dr. Raghavan and internationally accepted or acclaimed scholar in the field of Sanskrit, especially in the field of literature, Alankara Shastra, Shaivagama, and she was a mentor for most of us. A very simple person with very deep knowledge in so many branches of Sanskrit studies. She inculcated a lot of discipline and academic integrity. The most famous word of Dr. Janaki was integrity. And she was always fond of telling that this is a place of learning, temple of learning, and this is full of vibration. These two phrases she used to repeat so many times every day. Full of vibration and temple of learning, that is what she used to say. And she had two PhDs, one under Professor Raghavan, which we have published, Gadya Karnamrita. Her MLit dissertation was also published in Delhi, that was on Alankara Sarvasva of Ruyaka. And her second PhD was under another internationally renowned scholar, Professor T. Barrow from Oxford. And that was on the Bhanas, still to be published. And it was she who started doing a lot of research in Shaivagamic studies in this part of the country. Professor N.R. Bhatt of Pondicherry has edited a lot of Shaivagamas, and Dr. Janaki did a lot of studies on Shaivagamas with the assistance from her guru, Sri Sabharatna Sivacharya, who also served here as Shastra Chudamani professor. And Dr. Janaki mentored most of us. And even after her retirement in 1992, she continued to serve the institute. And unfortunately, she passed away all of a sudden in 1999 on May 5. And in memory of such a great person, whose portrait you can see here, she adorns the center of the hall here as if telling us that she is always looking at us. That's what I always used to feel whenever I have some classes here. She used to smile and as if reminding, I wanted to teach you so many things, but you did not learn from me. She was a very vibrant scholar, very simple person. And after her sad demise in 1999, her family members wanted to perpetuate the memory of Dr. Janaki. It is not that we have forgotten her. As long as we live, she will always have a special place in our heart. And this endowment was started by the family members, her nieces, and her brother, Dr. Yajnanarayanan, is happily with us today, former professor at the IIT Madras, and some of us who worked under her. And we have been having endowment lectures every year in the month of July. And today, 15th of July, happens to be her birthday also, official birthday. It is the birthday of, we know, Sri Kamaraj, and Dr. Janaki's birthday is also July 15th. And it's a happy coincidence that we are having the endowment lecture today in her memory. And many scholars have voluntarily and willingly given lectures here. And she had so many scholars working under her, not only from Chennai, but from all parts of the world. Many of the scholars in USA, Canada, Europe, many countries from Europe, they all used to come here to learn texts, especially on Alankara Shastra or Saivagama texts under her. And she also produced some valuable literature with them, which have been published, and some of them are yet to be published. And we also published her papers like Sanskrit and Sangeeta, and then on music, Sanskrit and music. And the book that she edited, like Umapati Shivacharya, His Life and Works, Shiva Temple and Temple Rituals, they were all well received, and we have reprinted them. And one book that she wanted to bring out was Kriyakrama Dyotika or Aghora Shivacharya Paddhati, which has been lying with the Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts for a long time. They have not published it yet. We hope sincerely that it would come out soon. And this year, we have requested Dr. Ganesan from Pondicherry to give this endowment lecture under Dr. Janaki. Dr. Ganesan is internationally well-known scholar, especially in the field of Saivagama and Saiva Siddhanta. He has edited many Saiva Agamic text manuscripts, and also he has translated them. He has written a lot in this subject, and he has been with the French Institute of Pondicherry for a long time. He is 1 year senior to myself and Dr. Vasudeva here in Vivekananda College. We were in the first year of MA when he was doing in the second year. Later on, he went to the Adyar Library and got his PhD from the Madras University on the Neo Vedanta. So he is a very scholarly person, and he also got the Nanjundrao Gold Medal from the Vivekananda College for his proficiency in academic studies, for his contribution to social studies, as social work, as well as good understanding of Hinduism. And when we requested him, he readily accepted to come all the way from Pondicherry to give this lecture under Dr. S.S. Janaki Memorial Endowment. We are thankful to Dr. Ganesan for his ready acceptance. And under this endowment, we are also giving financial assistance to MPhil and PhD research scholars every month for their continuance of postgraduate research. So with this background of Dr. Janaki and a brief introduction about Dr. Ganesan, I would now request Dr. Ganesan to come and talk before us on the subject, important landmarks in the field of Saiva Siddhanta, which in which he is an authority. Over to Dr. Ganesan.
Thank you. ಯೋ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡಂ ವಿದಧಾತಿ ಪೂರ್ವಂ ಯೋ ವೈ ವೇದಾಂಶ್ಚ ಪ್ರಹಿನೋತಿ ತಸ್ಮೈ ತಗುಂಹದೇವ ಆತ್ಮಬುದ್ಧಿ ಪ್ರಕಾಶಂ ಮುಮುಕ್ಷುರ್ವೈ ಶರಣಮಹಂ ಪ್ರಪದ್ಯೆ. ಸದಾಶಿವ ಪದೋಚ್ಛಸ್ತ್ರ ಚಿದಂಬರ ಸಭಾಂತರೆ ಭಾವಯಾಮಃ ಪರಂಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಪರಮಾನಂದ ತಾಂಡವಂ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಾಮೇಶ್ವರಿ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕುಪ್ಪಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಲೀಗ್ ಬಾಲಸುಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣ್ಯಂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಸುದೇವನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಅಸೆಂಬಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ವೈಟೀಸ್, ಐ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ದಿ ಅಥಾರಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ KSRI ಫಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಡೆಲಿವರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್, ಎಂಡೋಮೆಂಟ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಾನಕಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಹಾನರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೆಷರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಶೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಸಮ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಹಿಸ್ಟರಿ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು. ಐ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ವೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸಿಟಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೀಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೈ ದ ಪ್ರಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಟು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಸಮ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹಿಸ್ಟರಿ ಆಫ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು. ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಏರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆನಿ ಕಮೆಂಟರೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಆಗಮಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಲಸಾಫಿಕಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮಟೈಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸೌತ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಜನರಲಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ನೌ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಇನ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೇಸ್ ದ ಹಿಸ್ಟರಿ ಆಫ್ ತಮಿಳ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಚುವಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟರಿ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ 7th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರ್ ಟು ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು ಕನ್ಯಾಕುಮಾರಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 1000 ಇಯರ್ಸ್, 7th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ಟು 18th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮೀ ಮೈ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ವಿತ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ದಿ ಹಿಸ್ಟರಿ ಆಫ್ ತಮಿಳ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಫೇಸಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ 6th to 7th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ಇನ್ ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ನಾರ್ಥನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 12th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ. ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ಸ್ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೌತ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಏಷ್ಯನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಸ್, ಶಿವ ದೀಕ್ಷಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಶಮಾದಿ ಆಗಮಾಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇಸ್. ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡ್ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ 11th to 12th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ವೆಲ್. ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೈಡ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ ಕಾಂಟಿನೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಏರ್ಲಿ ಮಿಡಿವಲ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಕಂಬೋಡಿಯಾ, ಜಾವಾ, ಇಂಡೋನೇಷ್ಯಾ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ. ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಟೆಕ್ಚರಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನಲ್ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ದಿ ಏರ್ಲಿಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ನೋನ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಶ್ಮೀರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾರ್ದರ್ನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇನ್ ದಿ 6th to 7th ಸೆಂಚುರೀಸ್. ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಶೈವ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ದೋ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್. ಕಮೆಂಟರೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್. ರಿಚುವಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯುಯಲ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಉತ್ತುಂಗ ಶಿವ 9th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ, ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ರಾಜಗುರು ಆಫ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾಟಾ ಸೌತ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್. ವಿಮಲ ಶಿವ 10th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ, ಹೂ ಹೈಲ್ಡ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಲಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕೇರಳ ಬಟ್ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಶಿ. ಸೋಮಶಂಭು 11th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ, ಹೂ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್. ಕಿಂಗ್ ಭೋಜ ಆಫ್ ಧಾರಾ 11th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ, ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ದಿ ವೆಲ್ ನೋನ್ ಶೈವ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯುವಲ್ ತತ್ವ ಪ್ರಕಾಶ, ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ವೆರಿ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮೆಂಟೆಡ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್. ದ ಸೌತ್, ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೌತ್, ಜ್ಞಾನಶಂಭು ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಶೈವ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಚೋಳ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ವಿಪ್ರೋ ತುಂಗಶ್ ಚೋಳದೇಶಿ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಶಿವಪೂಜಾಸ್ತವ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಹಿ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಹಿ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 11th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ, ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ದಿ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಸ್ ರಿಚುವಲ್ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ರಿಚುವಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯುವಲ್ ಜ್ಞಾನರತ್ನಾವಲಿ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಅನ್ಪಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ದಿ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಅಕ್ಲೈಮ್ಡ್ ಅಘೋರ ಶಿವಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಎ ಅನದರ್ ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೋಳ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ, ಹೂಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫಾದರ್ಸ್ ಮೈಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ಚೋಳ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ and at Chidambaram and other places. Agavala Shivacharya has contributed immensely for the propagation of and consolidation of Shaiva Siddhanta and other ritual systems through his commentaries and independent texts, the Opus Magnum being the Kriya Krama Dyotika in the mid 12th century. Trilochana Shiva, another great luminary who has succeeded Agavala Shiva as the head of the Amardaka Monastery, has also contributed to the Shaiva Siddhanta by writing independent texts. The most well known is Siddhanta Saravali and Siddhanta Samuchaya, etc. Next. Then coming to the Tamil Nadu, after the 12th century, due to Islamic invasions, Shaivism could not thrive in the north of India, and it found a very safer and fertile ground in the Tamil country, where already Shaiva devotionalism was very active from the 5th century, nurtured by Nayanmars. This later development of Shaiva Siddhanta, which I would prefer to call the second phase from 11th to 12th centuries, is an immense contribution by the Tamil genius. Then we have, in the beginning of the 13th century, Shivajnana Bodham, composed by Maikanda. It is one of the shortest ever philosophical texts that gives the essence of the Shaiva religio-philosophical system. This text had in fact inaugurated a new movement within the tradition of Shaiva Siddhanta in South India. For nearly 8 centuries, the entire development of Shaiva Siddhanta was based on this text through commentaries and sub-commentaries, whereby the Shivajnana Bodham has become the fundamental text, and the full edifice of the Shaiva Siddhanta of the succeeding centuries was built on this text. We have also, generally, scholars begin with Shivajnana Bodham, and they start the Shaiva Siddhanta in Tamil Nadu from Shivajnana Bodham. Fortunately, we have pre-Shivajnana Bodha texts, which I am going to talk more in detail. There appears to be some Tamil text based on the Shaiva Agamas composed before Shivajnana Bodha. The Shaiva Agamas were being studied in many of the Shaiva monasteries, such as the branch centers of the Golaki, Amardaka and other mathas. One such text is Jnanamradam, Nectar of Knowledge, is one of the surviving Shaiva Siddhanta texts. It predates the well-known Shivajnana Bodham. This text I consider as one of the landmarks in the history of Shaiva Siddhanta in Tamil Nadu. This ancient text, Jnanamradam, was composed in Tamil by one Vagisha Munivar, resident of Kodalambahai, which is the ancient name of Kodambakkam, near the modern city of Chennai, our Chennai. It attempts to give the essence of the Agamic teaching. This seems to be the first such a text in Tamil, giving the essential teachings of the vast Shaiva Agama corpus. Vagisha Munivar has extensively utilized such Shaiva Agamas as the Paushkara Agama, Mrigendra Agama, Kirana Agama, Suprabheda Agama, etc., as many verses in Jnanamradam are found to be the verbatim Tamil reproductions of verses from these Agamas. From the inscriptional evidences found in the Shiva temple at Thiruvottiyur near Chennai, Vagisha Munivar was first the disciple and later the head of the Golaki Matha at Thiruvottiyur. His teacher was one Chaturanana Panditar, a great Shaiva yogi, well versed in the Agamas, Shaiva Agamas. The great Chola emperor Rajadhiraja II had visited Thiruvottiyur when Vagisha Munivar was a resident at the Golaki Matha, and when the Chaturanana Pandita was the head. That was in the late 12th century. Later part of 12th century. In the same temple inscription, we find the statement Soma Siddhantam Vakkanikum Vagishwara Panditar. Regarding his teacher, we have Madamudaya Chaturanana Panditan. From this, it appears that the Golaki Matha was propagating Soma Siddhanta and even Kalamukha system, which is a variety of the ancient Pashupata system. All these systems are different schools of Shaivism, as the passage from the Suprabheda Agama says, Shaivam, Pashupatam, Somam, Lakulancha, Chaturvidham. Whatever it is, Jnanamradam is the first of its type available to us in Tamil. A complete Tamil treatise giving the essentials of the Shaiva Agamas composed in the 12th century. the beautiful Tamil verses are couched in Ahaval meter. What is more, this text actually consisted of all the four padas, Jnana, Yoga, Kriya and Charya, on the model of the Shaiva Agamas. But only the Jnana Pada portion is now available to us. In the Mahabhariyam on the Shivanyana Bodham, one or two verses from the Kriya Pada are cited. The Mahabhariyam was composed in the 18th century. So up to 18th century, the Kriya Pada section was also available. Poet and philosopher. The great teacher Vagisha Munivar seems not only a philosopher but also an accomplished Tamil poet. We find this fully in the entire composition. So for some instance I have started one Ahaval, especially the invocation verses. Endrai kadalelum vindoda ongiya chennichimayamum veengiya eelirum polilum venning uyirum alavil andamum ulaindri velaitham satta talara munnor illa munnon. Especially this is the invocation for Shiva. So this gives the essence of the Upanishads. Munnorkum munnor illa munnon valamali thotram eeru ondru illon. Then malarnda madar maragadavalli andivan taninirangavard sindeshella chelungiri oruval valangola padanda vannam pole aravol amarnda bahan. So always both in the Shivajnana Bodham, this Jnanamritam, as well as Shivajnana Chittiyar, Shiva is always presented as Ardhan Arishvara, and all the teachers they pay obeisance to the Ardhan Arishvara form. So Aravolar Amaranda Pahan, Turavor Kellayahi Tollon, Tanad, Paman Shevadi, Parava, Naman Bulada, Nalangola Chirande. Here I just want to, this is the rough English translation of the entire Ahaval one. We saw that Aravol Amaranda Bahan, Turavor Kellayahiya Tollon. So this is, he is the most ancient one, and he is the ultimate aim of all the renounced selves, Turavor, whom they want to attain. So the same you, we can, as Sanskrit scholars, we can easily remember the Kalidasa's well-known one, Kanta Sammishra Dehopi Avishaya Manasam Yav Parastad Yatinam in the Malavika Agni Mitra. So he is Ardhan Arishvara, Kanta Sammishra Dehopi Avishaya Manasam Yav Parastad. So he is even beyond the renouncer. And for the last one, Na Man Bulada Palm Paman Shevadi Parava Na Man Bulada Nalangola Chirande. So by saluting him, by singing his glory, I purify my tongue. That is the, for this we have the Shiva Mahimnastava one. Madhuspita Vacha Parama Mamritam Nirmita Vataha Tava Brahman Kim Vagati Suraguru Vismaya Padam Amatvetam Vanim Guna Kathana Punyena Bhavataha Punamiti Ityarthe Asmin Puramasana Buddhri Vyavasita. So the same view as we have in the Shiva Mahimnastava is corroborated here in the Jnanamritam verse. Then the title Jnanamritam. This nectar, Amritam, is capable of bestowing immortality on the selves by driving away their six enemies, Kama, Krodha, etc., as well as the ignorance that covers it, just as the nectar obtained by the gods is capable of destroying mortality. So that is how the explanation given by the author. Division. The entire Jnanamritam has been divided into different sections such as Samyak Jnanam, Samyak Darshanam, Paschachedam, Padi Unmai, etc. Then After enumerating the three fundamental categories, Pati, Pashu, Pasha of Shaiva philosophy, Vagisha Munivar takes up discussion on Pashu. The three states of the Pashu, Avastha, Kevala Avastha, Sakala and Shuddha Avastha are discussed in detail. The delineation of each one of these states closely follows the Shaiva Agama presentation. So the Kevala state. Shuddhan Kevalar Chottadi Nittan Meitah Gunamili Vyapi Moitu Mala Nani Punara Maraivo Nilan Yanai Chaidiyu Mariyon Bayil Amurtan Vali Ilan Achedanan Uli Ili Irayalan Maya Udara Mari Teya and goes further. Same is the, in fact, the Tamil translation, we can say, adaptation from the following passages from the Agamas. Achetano Vibhur Nityo Gunahino, Akriyo, Aprabhu, Vyaghatabhag, Asaktascha, Shodhyo, Bodhyo, Akalaha, Pashu. So this is the Kevala state. And the Suprabhedagama passage. Amurtasya Pashur Nityo, Nirguno, Nishkriyo, Aprabhu, Mayodaragato, Maya Udaramari, the same is Mayodaragato, Vyapi, Bhogopayeshu, Ashaktitaha. Sa Kevala Sviti Proktaha, Swapavan, Malabandhanat. So then Sakala state, Muran Mihu Kutra Muritta Varana, Yirin Kale Yamara, Vidindirin Chedanam Araya, Vichaya, Araya Tadail, Pungiya Ragam Punara, how the Sakala state, the actual state in the world, how it experiences, that is described in the verse, and the same is in the Kalod Balita Chaitanyo, Vidya Darshita Gocharaha, Ragena Ranjitaschasau, Buddhyadi Karanair Yutaha. Mayadi avani pariyante tatva bhutatma vartmani bhunkte tatrasthitan bhogan bhogaika rasikav puman. And the tatva sangrahavta sadyo jyoti pariyatati karma vashato bhupanaja deheshu ayamcha sarveshu. So even not only the agamas, even Jnanamrita author was well versed in the tatva sangraha, tatva traya nirnaya, the very most old, one of the earliest texts. So some of the earliest texts of Shaiva Siddhanta composed by Sadhyo Jyoti in the 7th 8th century. So it seems he has even studied, remaining in Thiruvottiyur, he has studied, and these texts were so widespread, and he has studied, and he has incorporated in the Jnanamrita. So the same one. Not only familiar with Shaiva Agamas, but also with such early Shaiva Siddhanta texts as the Tattva Sangraha, Tattva Prakasha, etc. Then, the inferential argument. Some of the Agamas of the Shaiva Siddhanta system utilize inferential argument as against the Buddhists who deny the very existence of a real, unchanging, conscious self inhabiting the psychophysical body. Jnanamritam resorts to full-fledged arguments to establish the existence of the self. The third sutra of the Shivajnana Bodha is exactly on this line. Netito mamato drekat akshoparati bodhataha swape nirbhogato bodhe bodhrutvat asti anuhu tanav. So, tanav anuhu asti, the self exists. And these are the arguments, all in the apadana karaka. Netitaha mamato drekat akshoparati bodhataha swape nirbhogataha bodhe bodhrutvat. These are five arguments. And Shivajnana Bodham ad Maikandar, same. Uladu iladu enralin, enadu ulal enralin, aimbulan urukkam aridalin, kanpadin, undi vinai inmayin, unartha unardalin, maya yendira tanuvinul anma. So this, I have not quoted the verses. In the Jnanamritam, there are two or three Ahaval verses which develops this inferential argument to prove the existence of a separate self. I have just quoted the Shivajnana Bodha, but he has in the Jnanamritam, we find the another same in the elaborate fashion. Then the Parishesha Anumana is also used by Vagisha Munivar in the Jnanamritam to prove the existence of the self. In verse 12 of Jnanamritam, we find the use of Parishesha, argument from consequence, to prove the existence of the self. The entire universe, composed of the element beginning from earth and extending up to nada, has been created by Shiva, but it is not created by him for his own sake. And Shiva does not create it without any use or purpose. Neither the world by itself can create by itself and enjoy itself. Therefore, as a conscious entity who enjoys this phenomenal universe, is the individual self. This is verbatim the same as we find in the Mrigendra Agama. Karyam kshityadi karteshah tat kartur nopayujyate na swarthamapi achit bhavat na anarthyam kartur gauravat parisheshyat parartham tat kshetrajnah saparah tayoho. In the Shivajnana Bodham also we have this same argument. I think in the 6th verse Shivajnana Bodha, 6th sutra, the same also we find in the Jnanamritam. So these are all parallels, and in fact we can say Vagisha Munivar or Jnanamritam is a precursor to Shivajnana Bodham, which follows in the next century. Then so Jnanamritam is not only a philosophical text, but it also gives the spiritual practices, and it incorporates some of the views and concepts from other Shaiva literature apart from the Shaiva Agamas. One such text is Shiva Dharmottara, human body a chariot. This idea has been very well presented in the Jnanamritam, for which the parallel is we find in the Shiva Dharmottara. In order further to prove the existence of a self inhabiting the body, the author compares the human body to a well-constructed chariot. The two legs are the two wheels, the hip bone as the axe, the central part of the body as the seat, the skin, etc., etc. As the charioteer drives the chariot, so also the self inhabiting the body controls it and leads it to achieve its purpose. This description is mostly the same as found in the Shaiva text Shiva Dharmottara. The original Sanskrit text has not yet been edited and published, but fortunately we have Shiva Dharmottara, a Tamil translation made by Nigamarayana Sambandar, Nigamarayana Deshiga, in the 16th century, which has been published, which has been widely studied in Tamil Nadu, Shiva Dharmottara. So from the manuscript, I am editing this text from the base of manuscripts, and the Shiva Dharmottara manuscripts are widespread throughout India and in Nepal also, and Nepal, Calcutta, in almost all lipis. So Shiva Dharma and Shiva Dharmottara were a widely text, and we have many inscriptions from the Chola kings, especially 10th, 11th, 12th centuries. Shiva Dharmam Vakkanik Nivandam. So many ancient Shiva temples under the Chola country, we have the inscription. They have institute endowed endowments for propagating and explaining the Shiva Dharma. So Shiva Dharmam Bakkanikam. So Shiva Dharma, Shiva Dharmottara, so both of them have not been published. So this is the verse which Jnanamritam has paraphrased in Tamil. Asti Asti Pattastula Stambham Snayubandaihi Suyantritam. The body, description of body, head as a charioteer. So this is very, very poetic description. So I have not given the Tamil Akaval verse, just I have stated the original, because Shiva Dharmottara passages. The long argument to prove the existence of a separate Anava Mala. So there are three malas in the Shaiva Siddhanta: Anava, Karma and Maya. So the existence of Anava Mala is a very one of the important concepts of Shaiva Siddhanta, for which to prove the existence of this Anava Mala, various texts take lot of space, and many passages are devoted. The same way Jnanamritam also devotes one or two Ahaval verses to prove the existence of a separate Anava Mala apart from Maya and the Karma Mala, etc. also. And the argument found in the Jnanamritam is very much the same as we find in the Mrigendra Agama, Pushkara Agama and Swayambhuva Agama. Yes. There's a passage. Evam mayanjanasto anuhu nija dosha tiraskritaha yati tanmayatam teshu maya bhogeshu ranjitaha. Then the Mrigendra Agama, I just cite the Agama passages which argue for the Anavamala. Yesham sharirinam shaktihi patati avini virtaye yesham tallingam autsukyam muktau dresho bhavasthitau etc. Then there is the Pashabhave Paratantriyam Mrigendra Agama Vaktavyam Kin Nibandhanam. Then Bandhashunyasya Pashita Drishta Baddhasya Pashyata Yetavatite Baddhatva Muktatve Baddha Muktayoho. So all the same is found in the Jnanamradam. Bandha Mahanror Bohiya Ishat Tanmai Iyandor Ashamal Bandhat Unrinar Ayinbulan Revalin Nindranar Veedum Kattum Yingidu etc. etc. It goes.
Yes.
So from the foregone discussion, we can definitely conclude that reading Shaiva teachers of the 11th, 12th centuries in Tamil Nadu were deeply read in the Shaiva Agamas as well as in the commentaries on those texts.